Hello, everyone, and welcome into another episode of Fallout. This is episode 4, which is called The Ghouls. Thank you so much for joining me, and as always, thank you so much for your support. This episode title has me excited because so far in this show, we have only seen one ghoul, the ghoul. This title is now indicating we're going to get more, which is really fun. So I'm not going to chat here any longer. Let's just get into the episode.
He killed my husband. If your father were here, he'd do the right thing.
Such a complex thing. There's no right or wrong way, I feel. I'm very curious to see what's going to happen in the vault.
Thou shall get sidetracked by bullshit every goddamn time.
I love that line so much because it calls out the games and how many side quests you get in the games, which is an absurd amount. One thing I haven't mentioned yet is my desire for the song Big Iron to play. They have to put it in the show. If they don't, I will riot. I am waiting for Big Iron. Some of these buildings still look pretty good for being here for 219 years. Can we just talk about that?
My name is Russ.
Why are you making her go and invest? Oh my God, brother.
My name.
Is this going to be a feral ghoul, though?
Hey, Raj.
Hey.
You up for that bounty, too, huh?
Wow, that effects work is fantastic.
Oh, shit.
It's hard out here. Dang, some of these can be so unkind.
Yep.
I think you got a smoothie of your own.
You turn it.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, you don't have to have any vials, do you?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Roger. I'm all out.
It's okay. Might want to clear out before things get ugly.
28 years since I first started showing.
Wow, this is so good. It's also very heartbreaking.
Not as long as you, though. You've outlasted us all. How long?
A long time.
That's a lot of vials.
Well, I've always been good at making money, Roger. Remember how good food used to taste?
Blamco mac and cheese.
Blamco mac and cheese.
Ah, damn! Apple pie! You know, my mom used to...
Stop, please. I know it's hard up here, but you don't.
Money. Teeth.
What did you say your name was?
Lucy McLean.
McLean. It ain't all canned peaches and marmalade left up here, sweetheart. Sometimes a fella's gotta eat a fella.
You know, my vault has endured hardship, too. In the Great Plague of 77, everyone had to quarantine. People starved, my mother included.
Oh, no.
As what people say they did.
What they actually did.
And what they really did.
Yep.
How do you live like this?
Lucy, you...
Why keep going?
You've only been up here a few days, girl. This man's been around for 219 years.
Why the fuck am I doing all the work? Come on, Vaulty.
I love this duo. I won't lie.
Ass jerky don't make itself.
What a line. Oh my God. Ass jerky don't make itself. That's too good. This is what survival is, honey. Unfortunately. Love that intro. Oh wow, we're having an election.
I asked him all sorts of questions, who he is, who he works for, why his colleagues kidnapped Overseer McLean, organizing principle, if any, they operate under.
Nothing, huh?
I mean, that's kind of what raiders are.
Sir? Please stop. You will injure yourself.
Fuck you!
We better trank him again. We'll try again tomorrow.
I don't know that you can just do that over and over and over again. It'll make a difference.
There you are. Thought you might be up here.
You're not the only one that feels the absence of your father. And with your sister gone, you're the last standing McLean. Your voice carries more weight than you might realize.
Yeah.
During the raid, I got into storage space and I hid. Does that make you angry?
Why does it matter?
When clever boys like you are angry, you're lucky not to have seen where that can lead.
I didn't think this character would be a big deal after, like, episode one. I'm really glad that we are staying with the Vault and keeping up with them. It's a story that I'm invested in. The Vault and then these two. And I still care about Maximus, of course. I think these two, this is my favorite story right now. She is so thirsty. Have we found any Radaway yet?
Now you're getting it. How does that golden rule drive what's going through your head right now?
This guy.
What are you?
Oh, I'm you, sweetie. Give it a little time.
Oh, no. Oh, Lucy, what's the plan? Wow. Wow, look at that. Oh. Oh.
There you are, you little killer.
That angle of his face was the first time that nose looked fake. This bitch went, you're gonna take my finger?
Right there.
I'm gonna take yours.
It's the closest thing we've had to an honest exchange so far.
Oh my god. I love this show. Holy shit. That was great. Lucy's learning. I still hope that it's kind of gonna go the other way, though. I hope that she can, like, mind coop what humanity used to be. Oh, well, that looks fucking delicious.
I thought I'd just stop by and see how you're doing.
Not great, to be honest. Mm. How are you handling the death of the father of your unborn baby?
Great way of putting that.
I was actually just organizing some of Bert's things, and, well, I thought maybe you might want.
Are these
some
two
of
about to
get him talking about shoe maintenance, and he'd just carry on until everyone left the room? I loved him so much. It would mean a lot to me if you took Bert's shoes.
I'll try to wear them.
This is so awkward.
Oh, Bert.
Oh, Bert. Oh, Bert.
Oh, Bert.
Yep, yep, yep. Saw that coming a mile away. Fabulous song choice for this scene.
You just keep it on, will you?
Oh, yeah, of course. I'm sorry. What were you thinking?
Yeah. Bert.
Yes. I am Bert.
Poor Bert.
Now that is one wet lady.
That's, what a scene. Super duper Mart. Here we go. Oh, I totally forgot that she's missing a boot.
Transaction?
Yes?
2 months supply of owls, exchange one female, mint condition. Near mint condition.
Condition grading requires physical evaluation.
I don't want this to be the end of these two.
Best you try your luck behind that door.
I feel bad for Lucy.
Welcome.
What the fudge?
Oh my
fudge.
Gosh.
There's no fudge.
Wow, that looks good.
I've been kidnapped. He's right outside.
I say you've lost a finger. Let's get you taken care of. Follow me.
That's amazing. I'm so happy. I could tell when the voice was coming through the speaker, so I was really looking forward to seeing what it looked like.
The Great War. That must have been a week ago at least.
Yeah, a week ago. Mm-hmm.
Too fat, too withered. Ah, this one will do it.
Thank you. I really do appreciate this.
Lucy is so kind. A big fish ate my head.
That feels really, really nice. I mean, I thought I was here to be a sex slave.
What? What a disgusting idea. I'm simply going to harvest your organs.
Huh? Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no!
Hey, Norm.
Veronica.
Wait, they're getting Jell-O cake?
Those are my orders. Do you want it? Nobody's gonna know.
What is his plan?
What are you looking at?
A murderer in a cage, paying the price for what you did to us, for what you did to the innocent people in Vault 32.
It was anything but innocent.
Can't wait to find out more. What was going on here? All right, I'm here for this investigation.
Norm. Hi. Feel like getting out of the house?
Yes.
All right, let's go exploring.
This isn't exactly fun for me, Norm.
You know, why'd you come?
To be honest, I don't know.
You don't think it's because you're still in love with my sister and being around me reminds you of her?
Did you guys bring a flashlight or something? Answer is yes. Don't mind me forgetting that flashlights are built into Pip-Boys.
You see? Whatever happened here happened a long time ago.
Well, yeah, that body we saw in episode one was, like, decomposed for a long time. You'll need to go farther into the vault. Past this, past that room.
The last biosignal detected was 2 years ago.
So that means then that their trading was once every 3 years. Instead of 3 times a year. It's not a good way to go. We know the truth.
They were already dead when the raiders got here.
Definitely.
Who killed them?
I mean, it looks like they strangled each other.
I have a few different theories in my head right now. I'm thinking of all the different vaults I went into in the game. So literally all of that in the moment is like running through my brain, and I'm curious to see what direction they take Vault 32. Seeing her mom. Oh God, I hate this.
Martha.
Our latest arrival has arrived.
What are they asking, Snip-Snip?
60 vials.
Do her now so she's ready for the next pickup.
Snip-Snip. Very hygienic.
Sir, you can't do it.
How is she getting out of this?
Now don't be afraid. A little Snip-Snip and it will all be over. This won't hurt a bit. There's no fudge here.
Cool. Cool. Nicely done, Lucy. That was a really loud scene. Abraxo! Oh my gosh.
Hands up! Do as I say and Snip-Snip doesn't get hurt.
It's a fucking robot.
Yeah, you might as well be holding an air conditioner hostage.
Well, an air conditioner sounds nice.
I put Abraxo draining fluid in his syringes.
Okay. You can walk out of here.
Not just me. Them too.
All right. The title of this episode is now making way more sense, and I love it. You're free!
Hey, thank you!
Aw. Martha.
All of them!
Lady, those ones, you don't understand.
You gonna grab the vials too?
You're free!
I think Lucy's about to learn why they didn't open the doors for them.
Oh gosh.
Oh gosh, oh gosh. Yep, 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 yep. They're at the last stage of being a ghoul.
My name is Martha. Your name is Martha.
Grab it, girl. Grab it, just in case.
Come on, I know there's someone in there. Talk to me!
There is. Now there's not. She's learning. Grab the vials. Let's go outside to Buddy. Give him the vials. And let's carry on as the duo.
Oh no.
I am so happy these two are exploring this vault. And the way that they've set it up set-wise is fantastic.
I think it's safe to say they went bananas.
It still doesn't explain how the Raiders got in.
True, very true. Yep. Death to management. Death to management, we know the truth.
If there were any survivors down here, they'd probably open the door and welcome the Raiders right in.
Logs. Robco Industries, yes. Oh my gosh.
It says it was open from the outside.
They'd need a Pip-Boy to open the door.
They had one.
No.
My mom's.
Oh, I'm so happy she got... Look at her. Hell yes. Okay, happy she got another shoe. Do you have the vials?
You don't get these. You turn into one of those. That how it works?
Yep.
I may end up looking like you, but I'll never be like you. Golden rule, motherfucker.
I also like that she, like, I actually like that she didn't get them all. I mean, he can easily go inside and get the rest if he wants to, and he probably will. But I like that she didn't grab all of them, you know? Oh my gosh, I love this shot. That is awesome. Oh my gosh. Man is ingesting every possible fucking thing in this room. Wow.
Oh, I'd love to share some of this with y'all.
This is great. One of his movies. Wow. Oh, I really wish Lucy was still here. Damn it.
Feo, fuerte y formal. Means he was ugly, strong, and had dignity. I'll give you 2 out of 3 on that front. I hope you like the taste of lead, you commie son of a bitch.
It's cool that we got to see how that turned out from the flashback scene where he was filming it in the first place. That's fun. Americorn. I just realized we didn't get Maximus. We didn't get Maximus at all in this episode. Man, this is just such a good show. I have literally nothing bad to say about it at all. Like, I am just still having the best time. I look forward to every new episode and just seeing new sets and continuing these stories and seeing what happens. And this episode was really great. And I honestly, like, I mean, I still really enjoy Maximus and his journey, but I didn't feel his absence really in this episode. Like, I only just realized when the credits hit that we hadn't seen him in this entire episode. So I think that just goes to show, like, the power of these two storylines. So let's talk about the vault first, because like I mentioned during the reaction, I honestly didn't expect as much vault time as I thought maybe we... What am I trying to say? Yeah, I didn't expect us to actually be in the vaults as much once Lucy left, but I'm really happy that they have chosen to like stay with that and follow Norm now. And so we have these essentially 4 main characters that we're following. We've got Norm, we've got Lucy, the Ghoul, and Maximus, right? I'm really, really fascinated by the vault because of the games. And I mentioned that I have a few different theories in my mind about what happened in Vault 32. Based on what we've seen, death to management written on the walls, we know the truth written on the walls, and a lot of people either offing themselves or killing other people in the vault. I'm tempted to not actually go into my theories really, because in a way it kind of spoils the games a lot which I really also don't want to do, like not from a story perspective, really. I know I've talked about the games a lot through these reactions, but I know that there's a lot of you watching that haven't played the games. So I don't really want to say too much, especially if some of you are watching for the first time with my reactions and you haven't actually finished the show yourself before watching these. So I'm just trying to be mindful, but all I'll say is that the vaults were not, and I think I might've mentioned this at the end of episode 2 or 3, I can't remember now, but like the vault, the idea of the vaults was like a good thing. But for like most of them, that didn't really work out. And I'll just leave it at that. I think that's the best way of describing it without really going into detail. So because of my experience with Fallout New Vegas and how many vaults you can go into in that game, and just seeing all the stuff that went down, I am really excited to see where they take this and what they've decided for this vault in particular. I'm interested to see if they have pulled a situation from one of the games, and it'll be fun for me if it's something that wasn't in Fallout New Vegas, because in my playthrough of Fallout 3, I mentioned that I've only played like 6 to 8 hours. I didn't actually get to the point where I explored a different vault from the one that I started in. I only know the New Vegas vaults and what happened there. And I'm almost positive that I didn't even make it to all of the vaults on the map. Even though I finished New Vegas and I put like 120 hours into that playthrough, I didn't explore everything. I did not go to every location on the map. I did not end up meeting all the people that you can. So there is a lot of gameplay that I missed. I'm so fascinated by where they're going to take this, and I'm really excited to see what Norm and Chet find. I love that they are going from computer to computer, because that's exactly how it is in the video games. Like when you go into a vault, like you just explore, you go into every single room, you open drawers, you log into computers, you password hack to get into the computers. And then you read logs and you read data and you read all kinds of things and you learn and you understand the stories that way. And so it feels like the show is doing that with these, and I'm here for it. I like if the next episode continues to just have them explore Vault 32 and just read logs and try and like piece together what happened, I will love that. I will love that. That's what I'm hoping for. That's what would be so fun. So we'll see what happens, but I am very, very invested in that, far more than I think I expected to. Because in episode 2, when we touched back on the vault, I kind of was like I still enjoyed it, but I also was just like, I wonder what's going to happen. And they're taking it in a direction that is very, very interesting to me. So I cannot wait for more on that. And Lucy and the Ghoul. Oh my gosh. I love these two together. And I know Lucy has gone now, so I anticipate that probably the entire next episode, maybe episode 6 as well, we're probably still going to have them split. I don't know when their paths are going to cross again at this point, but I'm very excited that Lucy is kind of understanding now. But at the same time, like, it is going to take a lot for her to really change. And I think that she is going to be very persistent in not doing that, because at this point, yes, she has lived her whole life in a vault, very sheltered and very optimistic and naive. And she's only been out of the vault for a few days. She is adapting fairly quickly, I would say. Her escape from this place, phenomenal. I loved that scene where she took down SNIP-SNIP, was his name? That was fantastic. And I'm glad that she also released the ghouls. Now she understands the state of feral ones. Roger. What Roger was going to turn into. Like, I like that we got that scene, but then later on we got like an actual demonstration of what Roger was about to become, so that not only could Lucy understand, but us as the viewers were like, oh, okay, I get it now. We can kind of understand now why Coop shot Roger just so point blank like that, and no hesitation at all, just killed him and immediately started just taking pieces off of him, right? And that is survival out in the wasteland. Sometimes you just got to be doing that. You gotta be doing things that you would never do in a normal civilized world, like cannibalism and eating dogs and more, just, yeah. Stuff that Lucy in her brain, I mean, would absolutely say no to, and it would be so hard to overcome that. But that's what I love about the Fallout games, is it shows survival, like just straight up survival. And I know that obviously the stories in these games and the show is very unrealistic, right? I mean, people would be dead, just straight up dead. The whole idea of ghouls and stuff is definitely not realistic. But I love stories that are kind of rooted in realism-ish, but is definitely more like fantasy, sci-fi-esque. So, and I think that this universe, the Fallout world, I think it does it really well. I think that it shows humanity at its worst, for sure, in many cases. But I also love that we have characters like Lucy, and then yourself, if you play these games. I mean, you can play someone like Lucy, or you can be like the ghoul. And that is totally up to you. And your environment will respond to you accordingly. And it's just so good. I can't get over how good this show is at just capturing the universe of this world. Or the wasteland. Like, it's just so well done. When I first heard him, I was like, oh my gosh, I can't wait to see him. And the visuals of him absolutely did not disappoint. I thought they were really well done. The visuals in this show just period have been great. The radiated bear from episode 2. Yeah, the radiated bear, which I forget the Fallout name for it. I think it starts with a Y. It's like a Yao Kai or Yao something, I think. I cannot remember the name of the creature, but the bear, we'll call it. The bear looked really good. The gulper, still my favorite visual of like some kind of creature. Although the rad roaches also look really good. And now we've got more ghouls, and I think the effects done to the really feral ones was really good, but also the effects on Roger and the effects on Martha were also really good. And they kind of remind me of clickers a little bit from The Last of Us. Very similar like category we could put them in. The sounds they make are very similar. The only thing with ghouls is that their personality stays far longer than the infected do in The Last of Us world. But yeah, I just think that like the sound effects, the visual effects, everything on that is just so well done. And SNIP-SNIP, I want to keep saying SNIP-SNIP, I'm sorry. But SNIP-SNIP, yeah, he looked really good. And it just has me more and more excited to continue with these next four episodes just to see what we're going to see, who we're going to see, everything like that. I can't wait. And there's a very good chance that I might actually binge watch the entire rest of the show today just because I really want to. But it's also going to like clear up some time for me over the next like couple weeks if I do that, which is also another reason why I kind of want to do it. So with that, I'm going to dive into episode 5 right away and continue on with this. As always, I cannot wait to read your comments. I'm so, so excited to do that and just talk more about this show. And let me know which story you're invested in the most. Let me know which character's your favorite. And also let me know if you just enjoy all of it. Let's talk about it. I'm having a good time. Thank you so much again for tuning in. We will catch you back here for episode 5. Until then, have a great rest of your day. Take care, everybody.